Yeah.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Yeah. Well, this is quite different from all the presentations we have had this morning. This is really connected with the DIH Hero platform because the DIH Hero is a European DHA, Digital Innovation Hub, and I'm going to present you right now a regional initiative that is supporting companies to acquire these new and innovative digital technologies so that they can improve their processes and products. This is the Basque Digital Innovation Hub, and also that this is coordinated by the SPRI, that is the Basque entity, well, the entity from the Basque government promoting the Basque industry. And they've got also a support program for the companies that is called Basque DIH Connexio. So I will talk about this right now.
No, it's not working.
I don't know where
it's me.
To...
Wait.
Okay.
Fine now.
Okay, thank you. So what is the Basque DIH? It's an initiative that, as part of the Basque Smart Specialization Strategy, supports industry in the experimentation and adoption of digital and sustainable technologies and innovation. So it consists of a connected network of assets, services, and infrastructures for training, research, testing, and validation of technologies available for the companies in the Basque country, especially the SMEs and the startups. So the goal of this initiative is to provide these industrial companies with the technological capabilities needed to meet the challenge of the three areas of the our smart specialization strategy: the smart industry, the energy, and health. This Basque DIH is co-owned by the technology centers, the professional training centers, and also the universities. And is supported by the public regional institutions. As you can see here, we've got in the Basque DIH 8 different nodes, all covering the three areas of the smart specialization strategy. And we are providing more than 250 assets. Assets are technologies, platforms that the companies can use. We are 34 members of the forming just this initiative, and we've got two nodes that are really relevant for the thematics that we are covering today in this workshop, that are the medical devices and digital health node, that is the one that are coordinating, and we've got another node on flexible and collaborative robots that is also coordinated by TECNALIA, by my colleague Damian Saye. So within this node, what we try to do is to help companies acquire these new technologies. The companies can contact us and we can advise them or assess them what problems they have, and we can propose them which technologies can be available. And then we can do different projects, proof of concepts or demonstrations or whatsoever, so that they can know what they need to apply. So what we are offering? We are offering this kind of services to the companies. We've got, as I said before, more than 250 assets. So you can find in the website of the Basque DIH all the assets divided into the 8 different nodes we have, so that we can cover all the needs of the companies. And finally, we are providing from the members of the Basque DIH 3 different types of services: technological and economic advice, so that when we see the need of a company, we analyze the needs. We also provide collaboration and co-working. We can provide technical foresights or state-of-the-art reports. And we can also do a proof of concept so that the company can see if this technology really fits their needs or really solves the problems they have. We also provide a design, prototype, and validation service that is more related with prototyping, programming, conceptual design, and we also advise companies about the technology transfer for industrialization. And finally, we provide training and awareness services. This is mainly demonstrations, showrooms, training workshops, and within this type of service is really important what we call the deep dive sessions that we offer freely to every company, every Basque company interested. These type sessions are really hands-on sessions that the companies can really test, they can really know the different assets, the infrastructures provided, and can have the opportunity to interact directly with the technicians that know about these new technologies. So I forgot to mention that it's very easy to contact the node. I mean, every company only needs to contact the node coordinator, and the node coordinator just assess the company in which services they would like to use, or which assets, or to which other member of the node he or she needs to contact. So just to provide you a brief glimpse of the medical devices and digital health node, we provide platforms for diagnostics and development of new applications and devices. We are 14 organizations, as you can see there, coordinated by TECNALIA, and we provide 51 assets in total to help the companies in these 8 fields of application, so that we provide assets really in the area of electromedical devices, orthopedic and rehabilitation technologies, in vitro diagnostics, laboratory equipment, medical image, digital health, biomedical consumables, and additive manufacturing. In all these categories, you can find rehabilitation robotics, you can find medical robotics, you can find medical image systems. So more or less the technologies we are talking today. And also we can find also some assets related to standards and regulation also to provide advice to companies. And now, just coming to the second half of my presentation, I will talk about this support program provided by the SPRI, that is the Basque DIH connection. This program, what tries is to support the companies to access, connect, and have knowledge of the Basque Digital Innovation Hub infrastructures, so the assets and all this. It has a budget for this year of €1,100,000. And it's targeted to the industrial bus companies. So every company can apply, just presenting a proposal, and it will open in June this year. And the deadline for proposal submission will be in October. So, but you can just start as a company, you can just start thinking about the project you will like to implement or to develop, because the actions, the eligible actions, can start since the beginning of this year and need to end up before December this year. So what this program finances? It finances technical support projects led by industrial companies. And this project can be of two different types. It can be the development of an action plan, the capacity of the company, so that they can learn and apply the new digital and sustainable technologies, or it can be the development, the realization of a proof of concept of a technology. I think that this robotic for healthcare technology, this rehabilitation robotics can be applied in my company to solve this problem because I want to. So you can just perform, make an application just on the proof of concept of this technology. And what is this? The grants of this program are allocated on a basis of successive granting. This means that it's not a competitive call. So the projects are selected on a first-come, first-served basis. So if you just submit the proposal, the first one, I mean, your proposal is evaluated, and if it fits the conditions and the terms of the program, you can receive the funding. And what is the maximum funding? It's 80% of the total eligible expenses with this maximum amounts. €2,000 in the case of collaboration with government agent, with one technology center that is providing this asset of this technology. If you are working with two different centers, two agents, you can receive €20,000. And in the case you are working with a European Digital Innovation Hub, which could be the case of a DIH Hero or another European Digital Innovation Hub, you can receive €15,000. And you can also allocate in your budget €3,000 for travel expenses. And which are the eligible expenses? Only the cost for the work of the agent, that is of the agent of the Basque DIH. I mean, the cost for the for the work of your the personal costs of the company are not eligible. So that is very important. And you can have two projects granted in this program. So this is new from this year. Last year it was only one. This year you can, as a company, you can get two. And just to show you, just to finish the presentation, I show you here some figures from the last call of last year. So you can see the eight different nodes, and you can see the projects that were granted in this program. In the medical devices and digital health node, we funded projects, and in the flexible and collaborative robotics, they got 16 funded projects. The difference between the numbers of projects allocated, you see, there are very few for your node. Oh, the problem is that we were constituted, our node just started working last year in June. So for us, it was a great success to have four projects since the call ended in October also last year. And the flexible robotics node is one of the nodes that has more years working in the Basque Digital Innovation Hub. And the other ones, so. And that's my side. Thank you very much. Any questions?